Blackstone Audio presents Consumer's Guide to a Brave New World by Wesley J. Smith. Dedication. To Mark Pickup. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Introduction. This book is about the human future. More precisely, it is about the power of biotechnology to affect the human future by harnessing our bodies at the cellular level, first to employ them as raw material in the manufacture of medicines, and ultimately to transform what we commonly regard as human nature. In these pages, we will explore the scientific, moral, and business aspects of cloning, embryonic and adult stem cell research, and genetic engineering. We will consider the potential for miracle medical cures and the prospect of fabricating designer babies. And we will ponder the tremendous impact these activities are bound to have on us all. Few contemporary issues are as important or as controversial. The decisions we make today about biotechnology will materially impact each of our lives and those of our children. This potent new science will transform society and conceivably even what it means to be human. For better and for worse, perhaps very much worse, biotechnology is developing the godlike power not only to improve our health and extend our longevity, but also to remake the biology of the human species. Issues that were once the exclusive domains of science fiction writers are now everyday headlines. In early 2003, the Raelians, a science cult fixated on flying saucers, made international headlines by claiming it had created the first cloned human babies. Biotech companies' press releases boast about developing medical products manufactured from tissues derived from the destruction of nascent human life. And with the successful mapping of the human genome, some bioethicists and futurists now urge that we use the information we have gained to manufacture offspring enhanced for greater intelligence, strength, and beauty. No wonder some observers fear, while others eagerly anticipate, that genetic engineering will steer us toward the creation of a post-human race. Experiments involving the very building blocks of life are already being conducted. A biotech company has patented a herd of goats genetically engineered to include spider DNA, so the herd's ewes produce milk containing spiderweb silk. The feat has been repeated with cows and hamsters. Cloning researchers claimed to have produced an early embryo that was mostly human, but also part animal. A mouse exists today with millions of human cells in its brain. Some biotechnologists and bioethicists look forward to the time when similar research will be conducted on human beings. But such surreal experimentation is far from being the whole story. Biotechnology holds extraordinary promise for alleviating human suffering in a greatly improved and fully human future. Scientists are learning how to treat illnesses utilizing the patient's own cells as healing medicines. In early human trials, patients' tissues have been put to work treating damaged hearts, Parkinson's disease, and multiple sclerosis. Still, many of these emerging technologies may have dual-use potentials, leading many to worry that they will be harnessed in the service of malevolent purposes. Self-described transhumanists advocate that we seize control of human evolution by designing genetic enhancements to improve the human race. As an example of this sort of thinking, the Nobel Prize-winning scientist James D. Watson, co-discoverer of the DNA double helix, has claimed that genetically enhanced people will someday...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.